Hi, and welcome to this video on UiPath with me, Jeppe. This is the second part in a two-part video about the object repository. I'll try to summarize in this one what we did in the first video, but otherwise you're welcome to go back and there's a link to that video in the description below. So let's get to it. So if you remember from the first video, we tried to take a look at how we can use the object repository to promote reuse of selectors within UiPath Studio. I mentioned that if we had, for example, four automations that all used the same application, then all four of those applications would be tied to how that application looked at the time of the development of the automations. So I have built four simple automations, one called even numbers, one called uneven numbers, one called low numbers, and one called high numbers. And they will just click some numbers in this calculator number pad, and then finally it will clear these numbers using the clear button here. But what happens when this application changes? That's what we're going to look at now. So let's jump into Studio. Okay, so what we have here is a very simple automation that uses the object repository to automate the MyCalculator application. And in my packages, I have referenced a package that is deployed to my orchestrator. So that gives us these elements over here in the object repository, mainly the calculator app, the main screen of that app, and then the buttons that I have defined descriptors for, as we saw in the first video. Then I have taken this main screen and dragged it into our sequence. And inside that sequence, I have then a number of click activities that click in this case, because this is the even numbers automation. It clicks the 2, 4, 6, 8, and 0 button, and then finally it clicks the clear button. And on the clear button, I have to find a very short timeout of just 1 second, because we will try to make this fail in just a few minutes. So if I close this project and show my UiPath assistant, these are the four processes that I have deployed to my orchestrator, and they all use this version 1.0 of the MyCalculator application. And if we run the first one, the even numbers, we can see that it will click 2, 4, 6, 8, 0 and then clear those numbers. If we run the high numbers, we'll see a similar behavior. Low numbers. And we'll also do the last one, uneven number, uneven numbers, just for good measure. And that was just a little bit outside the screen, but that's okay. So we have these four applications, but what happens if I go into this folder where I have my calculator application and replace that application with a new version of the application? So that instead of version 1.0 being in this folder, we now have version 1.1, as we can see here. We can see that the clear button has been moved, and behind the scenes, we'll also know that the clear button's name inside the code of the application has changed from button 10 to button clear. So if I run the same automations again, first the even numbers, we will see that it does what it's supposed to until it hits the clear button, but it can't find the clear button anymore. And the same will happen with the other automations, and I'll run through them just for good measure again. So we'll do the low numbers. And again, that fails as well. And we will do, of course, also the high numbers. Again, that's a little bit outside the screen, but you can see what's going on. So we just had four automations fail, and we don't want that. But in order to fix that, if we hadn't used Object Repository, we would have to open all four of these projects in Studio and then change the selectors for the clear button for all four projects, deploy all four projects and test them and all of those things. And we don't really want to do that. We want to make it a little bit easier for ourselves. So I will hide the assistant and jump into Studios. And this is the descriptors project. So if I open the MyCalculator application again, and I will just reduce the size of my studio here. Then the problem was the clear button. And if I right click that and edit the descriptor, then we can see that it's pointing into just sheer nothingness because there's no button here. So we will delete this selector. We will create a new one. And I'll leave the fuzzy and image selectors in here this time. And I'll click confirm. And what I'll do now is I'll go into Orchestrator. And I'm in the tenant menu. And I'll go into the packages. And we can see that we have our four automations sitting here as packages. And we have one library sitting in here. And if we go back to the packages and just quickly take a look at the even numbers package, for example, explore that and look at the dependencies, we can see that this one is dependent on the version 1.0.1 of the descriptors package. So going back into Studio, what we can do now is we can publish this new version of the descriptors package. That will get version 1.0.2. And I'll publish it not to my desktop, but to my Orchestrator. And that went well, I hope it did. But what we can also do is we can go into the home menu here and go into the tools. And there's a tool up here called the Project Dependencies Mass Update Tool. And that's a long name. But what that can do is it can look at the projects that you have on your local machine, but it can also do the deployment of those updated packages. So if I click this tool, and first I'll just click next, and this will give me the option of updating the dependencies for stuff that I have in this these folders that it just scanned. And we have, of course, the calculator app.descriptors project. And I'll select that, click next. It'll ask me, what file location do you want to check the projects in? And for me, I will just go to this PC documents UiPath folder. This is where I have both the descriptors project, but also the high, low, uneven, and even numbers projects. So I'll select the main folder there, click next, and it'll scan that folder for projects that might need updating. And I'll select to update the even numbers, high numbers, low numbers, and uneven numbers projects, and click next. Where do I want to publish to? I want to publish to my tenant feed. And when it does that, what happens is that it will take a little while to go through all of these projects, rebuild them, republish them, and I'll get back to you once that's done. Well, it goes pretty quickly, actually. So we'll just wait. There we go, it's finished. And if I now close, it doesn't want to close for some reason. There we go. And if I now go into Orchestrator and go into the even numbers, explore the package, we can now see that this package has version 1.0.2, and this is the automation number that has that version number. And we can see that if you go into the dependencies of that package, that is dependent on the new version of the descriptors. So all in all, this means that instead of me having to update four different projects, rebuild those projects, test them, republish, and all of those things, we just did it all with the Project Dependencies Mass Update tool, which is really nice. And that saves us a lot of time and a lot of errors that we will avoid making when doing those kinds of tasks. So one more thing that we need to do before we go back to the assistant is to go into our default folder where the processes or the automations live. Go into the automations folder here, and we can see that there are updates available for all of these four processes. And we can also see that the current version is 1.0.1 for all of them. If I click this box here, it'll select all of them, and I can opt to upgrade all of those packages in one go. And now they are all up to date with the latest versions. So if I go back to my assistant here in the main screen, we have these four processes that failed just a little bit earlier. And if I rerun these, we should then see them run with the latest version of the library with the descriptors that we built in our object repository. So I'll start with the uneven numbers and we'll see if it runs. It does. Does it? It finds the different numbers and it finds the clear button and it closes. And the same thing, hopefully, with the even numbers. It did. And we'll do these two last ones as well. That worked fine, and this one should work as well. Great. So again, just to summarize, we went from having four different processes that each had its own selectors for these buttons built into it. And that meant that once the application changed, we needed to either go through all four of these automations and change the selectors in those, or what we could have done and we ended up doing was building an object repository that knew about these selectors, and each of our four automations then used that repository so that when the application changed, all we had to do was rebuild the object repository, use the mass update tool in UiPath Studio, and really the build and deployment of these four new versions of the applications or automations was really very, very easy. So hopefully you got an impression of how to go about this in your daily work. If you liked the video, if it wasn't a complete waste of time, hit the like, hit the subscribe button, maybe even the notification bell, and make sure that you check out the first part of this video if you haven't seen it. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.